Sometimes I'm not fully informed, not necessarily deliberately, but due to circumstances. And now we take our pens, we have our columns, we can speak very good English, we start drawing grammar. At the end of the day, without taking into consideration the implications of some of the things we are seeing. A lot of these things, if I start opening up to you now, even on the misrepresentation of the Boko Haram, I have a back full of newspapers that say things that are in error. But these things, we take them as not necessarily deliberate mistakes. These are the things that will happen here and there. And then Nigeria is a big country of about 200 million people, 973,000 kilometers, so many things. So these things are bound to happen, but we shouldn't allow them to fundamentally subvert our institutions and our systems.
As a people may think that what you are talking about is not true, but the fact that we have gotten to the level where that can be reported at all, we have not in any way done well. He said, well, the editor will not accept. He said, let me give you the editor's number. If you cannot convince him that that is not a worthy report, then let me talk to him. So the issue is that we must come to realize that we are fighting a war, and that when we report certain things, it is to the advantage of the terrorists. I was having this issue with the Femi Adesina. I was a commandant of Army School of Foreign Relations and Information. I do invite him for lectures during our yearly media workshop. And he was insisting that the media has a duty, and the duty they have is to reform the public. I said, not everything is reformed. Right now, the responsibility the media have to the public is more than before. Whenever you want to bring out the report, you must understand what is the danger, how will it affect the general public before you report it.
When we want to inform the public, the question we should ask ourselves, first and foremost, does this build our nation or does it divide our nation? And I think it's the unanimity of our profession and our nation's self-interest that we should build the nation. If we are going to report casualty figures, destruction and cutting away of our equipment, and it panics the whole state or sub-region, northeast region, and every person starts forming IDP camps in Abuja, in Lagos, in Edo State, have we helped to build our nation by such reportage?
I am appealing to the journalists, having understand where the military are coming from. You know, this one, they gave us facts. And to me, it's nothing new, because I have been having a select few journalist briefings where they tell us what is not publishable, but for our knowledge. And when I go back to my newsroom, if you come with a story that will bring trouble in this country, I always say, no, I step it down, or I water it down in such a way that we will say the news so that we don't come and react when we have not broadcast the story. But I will make it in such a way that the whole world will understand, yes, something is happening, but this is what has been done, and people should not fear. So these are the kind of understanding. If all of us, we should avoid overzealousness. We should avoid situation whereby we would put this country on fire. If we allow patriotism to come into us as they are preaching to us here, I think Nigeria would be better for you and I to do our job.